Today I'm going to dive into a hot topic that many of you have been asking about: muscle loss while using GLP-1 drugs like Zepbound, Mounjaro, Wegovy, Ozempic, Tirzepatide, and semaglutide. We're referencing an intriguing and somewhat controversial article titled, "Don't Worry About Muscle Loss While Using GLP-1 Inhibitors." The author, Yale L. Maxwell, a senior medical journalist for TCTMD. Welcome to The Downsized. I'm Christopher Durham, and this is our channel that focuses on healthy weight loss with GLP-1s. We went through the whole list a moment ago, so I won't do it again. But let's dive deep into this concern, address the muscle loss question. Losing muscle loss can seem counterproductive on a weight loss adventure, especially when you hope to improve your health and fitness. According to experts reviewed in Maxwell's article, patients, some clinicians, pundits, and naysayers have expressed worry that rapid weight loss often experienced with GLP-1 drugs might lead to significant muscle loss. Flags raised everywhere, everyone's panicking, and they're worrying about potentially harming physical function and mobility. However, senior author Samuel Klein, MD from Washington University School of Medicine, assures us these fears are exaggerated. So what exactly is the real deal on muscle loss? Well, muscle loss, or the decrease in fat-free muscle, FFM, happens when any significant weight loss occurs. It's a natural part of the process, as our bodies shed fat and muscle when we lose weight. However, the critical takeaway from Maxwell's article is that the decrease in FFM relative to baseline is usually minimal. More importantly, the reduction in FFM is less than in fat mass, meaning overall physical function can improve with weight loss from GLP-1 drugs. To understand this better, let's break down fat-free and skeletal muscle, or SMM. So FFM and SMM, it's a lot of letters. Fat-free muscle includes all the components of your body except fat. This means your muscles, bones, water, and organs. On the other hand, skeletal muscle mass refers explicitly to muscles attached to your bones, which are crucial for movement and overall physical function. But if you have a digital scale like we do, it actually measures both of those things, and you may have wondered, well, what the heck are they? Let's take a look at the expert opinions. Well, Dr. Klein and his esteemed colleagues, including Katarina Conte, MD, PhD, and Kevin D. Hull, PhD, have outlined in their JAMA viewpoint that data doesn't support the concern that GLP-1-induced muscle loss leads to physical frailty. It's not that you don't lose anything, it's that it does not cause physical frailty. Instead, they emphasize that these drugs make individuals more functional and physically active, a significant benefit that should reassure you. So let's take a look at the benefits of GLP-1 drugs, and we all know that if you're watching this channel. So why are these drugs considered beneficial to begin with, despite the minimal loss? Well, let's delve into the mechanisms of GLP-1 drugs. We talk about these things constantly here on The Downsized, but let's review anyway. GLP-1 receptor agonists work by mimicking the effects of natural hormone GLP-1, glucagon-like peptide, in the body. This hormone regulates appetite and food intake, promoting the feeling of fullness after eating, thereby helping reduce overall calorie intake. Additionally, GLP-1 drugs have been shown to improve insulin sensitivity and have cardiovascular benefits, which are critical for patients with obesity-related issues. Michael Albert, MD, who runs a telehealth obesity clinic, has shared that worries about muscle loss are primarily hypothetical. In his experience, and based on existing evidence, these medications do not make patients frailer. On the contrary, many patients report feeling more energetic and more robust. This anecdotal evidence from Dr. Albert's practice aligns well with broader scientific consensus, reinforcing that the functional benefits of weight loss with GLP-1 drugs outweigh the concerns of muscle loss. We see a lot of the myths in the media. You get questioned if I'm at a party. You know, they're asking about them all the time. Johns Hopkins University's Michael Blaha, MD, pointed out that fears about muscle loss often stem from social media rather than clinical evidence. In today's digital age, misinformation can spread quickly, and it's essential to differentiate between credible sources and anecdotal reports. Dr. Blaha emphasizes that while muscle preservation is necessary, it's extremely important. It's not a primary concern for most patients. Instead, he advises them to focus on strength training and adequate protein intake to maintain muscle mass while losing weight. If you've listened to Lorraine and I talk about this much, you've heard us talk about both exercise and protein a lot. Lorraine will tell you to eat 100 grams of protein a day in almost every video. Furthermore, strength training and diet is a continuing concern. Let's discuss those. Strength training or resistance training is crucial for preserving muscle mass. Weightlifting, resistance band exercises, or bodyweight exercises such as push-ups and squats stimulate muscle growth and maintenance. Pairing these with a protein-rich diet can further help preserve muscle mass. Proteins are the building blocks of muscles, and consuming enough of them ensures your body has what it needs to repair and build muscles. These are the practical steps you can take to maintain your muscle mass while using GLP-1 drugs. Dr. Albert suggests extra caution is needed for elderly patients and those with significant weight loss exceeding 25%. These groups might require additional monitoring and a tailored approach to ensure their health isn't compromised. Elderly patients, for example, are naturally prone to losing muscle and bone mass as they age, a condition known as sarcopenia. This can make them more susceptible to frailty and falls. Monitoring their muscle mass is crucial to ensuring adequate nutrition and physical activity. For patients experiencing more than 25% weight loss, the concern is not just about muscle loss, but also overall health and nutritional status. Rapid and significant weight loss can sometimes lead to deficiencies in essential nutrients, which is why a balanced approach is necessary. Regular testing and blood work can help track these changes and guide treatment decisions. So as we look forward, what are the future developments? What's the ongoing research? So when we talk about the ongoing research into drugs that might preserve muscle mass during weight loss, one area of interest is activin type 2 receptor, ACTR2. Inhibitors, which are being explored for their potential to prevent muscle loss. While promising, it's important to remember that these are still experimental. Dr. Blaha experienced some skepticism, noting that these medications might be abused or used in the wrong setting. It is crucial to approach new treatments cautiously and rely on solid evidence before integrating them into your healthcare. We always get pushback on lifestyle. Well, you can't just take the drug. It's not a magic bullet. Are you going to change the way you eat, the way you live? And of course, as we have these conversations, the drugs facilitate this and make weight loss possible for many. The lifestyle changes are the ones that are harder and the ones that are bigger. So I want to reiterate the crucial role of changing what we eat. We've got to change the way we live alongside these drugs. Weight loss is a multifaceted process that benefits from a comprehensive approach. While GLP-1 drugs significantly aid in weight loss, they are most effective when combined with changes like a balanced diet, regular physical activity, and behavioral modification. Theoretically, if I change what I'm eating because the drugs have helped me do that and I become healthier and I take the next year, the next 2 years and build new habits, it'll be easier to maintain my weight. Let's talk a little bit about the dietary considerations. Focusing on whole nutrient dense foods is key to a healthy diet. Add plenty of fruits, vegetables, lean proteins, whole grains, and healthy fats to meals. Avoid processed food, sugary beverages, and excessive amounts of unhealthy fats. They make me sick now with the medication anyway. All of these things can help us achieve and maintain that weight loss that we're striving for. For those on GLP drugs, paying attention to protein intake is, of course, as we've already said, beneficial to support muscle maintenance. Foods like chicken, fish, beans, lentils, tofu, and Greek yogurt are excellent protein sources. And of course, we'll harp on the exercise and physical activity. Again, physical activity is another critical component. Aim for a mix of cardiovascular exercises such as walking, running, cycling, or swimming, and strength exercises. Cardiovascular workouts help burn calories and improve heart health, while strength training helps maintain and build muscle mass. Consistency is vital. Find activities you enjoy and can sustain over the long term. We're all at a different place in our weight loss journey. We're all at a different place in our health. We all weigh something different. So do what you can do. I don't know your story. I don't know your journey, but we can all do something. The behavioral modifications can also play a significant role. This includes setting realistic goals, tracking progress, and seeking support from friends, family, or support groups. Mindful eating practices can also be beneficial, such as paying attention to hunger and fullness cues and avoiding emotional eating. Fortunately, GLP-1s help us considerably with that. I don't run into emotional eating really at all. And I have to pay attention to what I'm eating because I'll feel terrible if I don't. The real point, though, is we have to manage expectations. It's extremely important. The cliche of weight loss is that it's a journey, and we say that all the time. All the YouTubers say it, the TikTokers. I prefer to call it an adventure, but the sentiment is the same. You will experience ups and downs, fluctuations and stalls. This is a marathon, not a sprint. Celebrate small victories and stay focused on improving health and well-being overall. Remember, the number on the scale is just one measure of progress. Improvements in energy level, physical fitness, and overall health, not to mention different size in your clothing and being able to go up and down stairs more easily. They're all important. GLP-1s are a valuable tool, a valuable way to treat the disease of obesity. And these medications are not a magic bullet. If we maintain a balanced perspective that includes medication, lifestyle changes, and ongoing medical support, we can have long-term success. So what's the bottom line? You will lose muscle, but it is not the end of the world. Do not let the exaggerated fear of muscle loss stop you from taking the medications. Focus on taking care of yourself, eating protein, drinking water, exercising to the best of your ability, and I assure you the benefits far outweigh any potential muscle loss. Thanks for joining today's discussion on the benefits of GLP-1 drugs and muscle loss. Stay tuned for more insights from Lorraine and I on our health and wellness journey. I'm Christopher Durham, and this is The Downsized. Please like and subscribe. Thank you very much.